Good morning, Graham. Welcome. This is another webinar that we're providing for our members. And today's webinar will be about 10 different techniques on how to promote your art. And we've got our arts marketing expert, Graham Stevenson, in the house. So welcome, Graham.
Good morning, Nat. How are you?
I'm great. It's a beautiful day. Hi, and I'm happy to see your smiling face on the screen.
Okay. Well, let's get started on this. I mean, there's many different techniques that you can obviously help to market your art. Funnily enough, you know, if you're a reasonably established artist, as the years go along, you've always got to be careful of this for a start, but to raise your prices. I sort of find sometimes that artists actually undervalue what they're doing, and people, collectors, sort of question the situation, sort of, why am I paying so less, or, you know, not enough for the work. So in raising your prices over a period of time, I mean, once you've established yourself, you know, 5 to 10 years of really working hard, make sure that on an annual basis that you put your prices up only a little bit. But I mean, what can happen sometimes with artists is that they can raise their prices so high that they literally put themselves out of the market, and then when they want to sell at a future date, you know, literally nobody wants to buy them, and you can't really drop them down either, because the people that have paid good prices for them get quite upset when all of a sudden the same size painting is half the price that it was when they bought it 5 years beforehand. So raise those prices, but raise them gradually. Include some testimonials from the people that have bought your work when you're approaching other clients. And it's great for the galleries as well, in regards of, you know, people that you've come across that enjoy your work that might be well established themselves. You know, put that in with the material that you put out as well. Talk about the benefits of your art as well. You know, why would people, you know, buy your work? You know, what's good about it? Is it spiritually inclined? Are there great landscapes? Would it go well in a particular part of their house? You can do this by getting to know people quite well. Don't initially try and sell something to somebody if you're in a gallery or a trade show, but ask them about their home, their biggest asset, and find out what their home is like, and get into their head and into their home. Because it's their home, you're going to find out if it's a Spanish type home or if it's a modern home, and if your work's going to work well in there at all. And find out, you know, ask if they've got a fireplace, how big is the lounge room. Just ask questions about their asset, the thing that they're proud of. And then basically you can say to them, well, you know, that painting would probably go really well in that section right beside the fireplace in the corner there. And they start to, you know, get involved themselves with your work, going, yeah, that's probably a good idea. Offer bonuses for your work. I mean, if somebody's a little hesitant on something, you can sort of go, well, how about I throw in a print for you as well of something else that, you know, you would like, or you can give this to your mum or whatever, so that you've got an excuse to keep the sale going, instead of them sort of saying, oh, I'll think about it. Sort of say, before you walk away, hang on, I'll give you one other thing as well. Or offer them to buy two and reduce the price for them. So they can go, okay, so you benefit and they're benefiting. They're spending more money, but they're getting more work at the same time. And so some artists have got an exchange policy where, you know, you'll exchange the artwork 2 years down the line. So if they get to the stage where they say, I don't particularly like it, it motivates the buyer to come back as well. So you can sort of say, yeah, sure, not a problem. You can exchange that one, because the buyer's coming back to you then. That's the thing. You want to keep that communication going. So the buyer comes back and says, you know, I'd really like to exchange it. Oh, hang on, I really like that. You go, well, they can exchange it for that. And then they go, oh, gee, I really like that one there too. So straight away, he's come back to exchange the one that he's got, but potentially he's about to buy another one. Or she. So you will find that the ladies will purchase a lot of the artwork, you know, for their homes, because it's their home, it's their pride and joy as well. Handle your art with care. You know, it's just not rubbish. It's something that you've created, and put cornices on your art and then wrap it properly when you're going to a show. So, and have that there. I mean, if you're at a trade show, and you're talking to people about your art, make sure you've got a painting that's possibly on the floor that's got the corners on it. You know, they can see the bubble wrap there and they can go, oh, hang on, well, this person really cares about what they're doing. They love what their work is, you know, so I'm going to value it at the same time. And then saying that, promote your value as an artist, your achievements and your awards. You know, what have you done? Well, you know, last year I was awarded the OAM. That's pretty fantastic. It's like, okay, there's only six artists in the country, as far as I know, that have got an OAM. So that was, you know, that's something that I've achieved. It wasn't expected by any means. But it was fantastic that it happened. So any of the things that you've done, make sure people know that. And not necessarily involved in art as well. I mean, I've lived in five countries. I've been around the world dozens of times. You know, just absorbing art and absorbing the planet and the animals and the way things go on. So that's part of your achievement and your story. So make sure you tell that to people as well. And also when you turn up, dress to impress. Most of the people that are going to be buying your work are going to be left-brained people. They can't do it, but they love and admire it. So if you're going to walk around like you've got the bum out of your trousers, it's sort of like that's your value. That's what you've done to yourself. I mean, I wear a suit or a sports coat when I do my talks or when I'm at a gallery. I don't come along. I mean, admittedly, as you know, I look like a bum most days because I've got paint all over me and I walk down the main street and people think I'm a vagrant. But in saying that, if I go to a client or I do a lecture or I'm in a gallery setting or at a trade show, you know, you dress to impress. And those other people that wear a suit are going to go, he's an artist, but he's just like me too. She's just like me. She's well presented. So make sure you do that. Explain the value of the materials that you use. I know that there's a lot of buyers, and I know them specifically, but they'll look at the back of the canvas. If they're buying a painting, they'll actually turn the painting over. It might look really impressive at the front, and a lot of artists can't afford to do this. I do occasionally, not always, depending on if I'm painting a really what I think is going to be a valuable painting. But your materials are your stretchers for a start. You get the best stretchers, not these thin little Chinese jobbies that you buy at the $2 shop. It's like if that's what you're putting your paintings on, you can expect to get paid for the fact that it's on a $2 canvas. You know, you're producing a $2 product then. Belgian linen, you know, that's what you're going to be using. You're going to be using the best that you possibly can, the best framing, so that there's value involved in that. I mean, the frame sometimes, and I don't frame a lot of my work these days, admittedly, but if I'm looking at artwork that I really like, it's sort of like, oh, I'm going to present this to its best quality. And I'll spend $400 or $500 or $600 on that frame to make sure it's, so when people come along, they're going to go, that's worth $12,000. It's worth $15,000. And then last but not least, which is what we do and what we specialize in, is it's share your creative process. Don't be afraid to do that. So if you're at a trade show or you're at a gallery or even if you can talk to somebody that's putting on a regional show, see if you can go along and be painting. Not on necessarily on the opening night by any means, but you know, generally openings are on a Friday night. So why don't you say to the gallery director, tell the clients that I'm going to be here working on a piece on the Saturday and Sunday. Because they're going to want to come along and go, oh, that's really cool. The artist is actually going to be there painting. So generally, that you know, the artist is there for the one night and he's sort of got off and gone. If you've got a show on for 2 weeks, you'd be doing that every weekend. Just so that people know, because when the gallery directors advertise that you're going to be there, I can almost guarantee that there's going to be a lot more people that come in because they want to see your techniques for a start, knowing that you're there and 80% of the time you're going to sell to people through the emotion of the story of your art and your career. So you're there. And that's the thing, and it's important because people will buy your artwork 80% of the time because of the emotion and the attachment that they have because they've personally got to meet you. And they're going to go, I really like this person. I love what they've done, what they've done with their life. I like some of them. And what they're doing is they're buying a part of your soul. That's the best way I can describe it. Your soul as an artist, they take that away. I mean, who wouldn't want to own a Rembrandt or a Picasso? Like just the story and the history behind it. So you're not just looking at the painting when you look at, you're looking at Picasso, Pablo, you know, the famous Spanish artist who was a womanizer and he was crazy. And then Rembrandt, you know, you're walking the streets with Rembrandt at the same time. So it's important that they get to know the emotion about what you're doing as well. So be there and be available and turn up to as many events as you possibly can just to get to know people, because people are there to buy art as well. And if you're well-dressed and you're well-presented, have your brochures and your cards with you. If you're a Colour in Your Life artist, have your Colour in Your Life show playing so that they can actually look at that as well. Because a lot of the artists have said it's been fantastic for them on that behalf. Really has been, because they may have a whole bunch of people in their booth talking away and even in the gallery. And if your show is there on a loop and they can actually see it on a little screen TV, they're going to be more likely to say, wow, that was really cool. I've got to know the artist while standing in the room and I never even spoke to them. So that's why it's important that what we do as well is that we facilitate those guys having a tool to on-promote themselves for years and years to come. So that's 10 that people can use. There's obviously a lot more that we can discuss as we go along. But I hope those things help people. And, we go from there.
Yeah, that's fantastic. I think you covered so many things there, Graham. That'll be very helpful. Thank you very much. And
cool.
We'll sign off from now. See you next time.
And yeah, bye-bye.
Don't forget to put some colour in your life.
Oh, absolutely.